What's happening, polite society? I hope you had a good week. The First Temptation of Christ is a Brazilian comedy, which was released by Netflix on December 3rd. The satire has caused outrage because of its depiction of Christ as a gay man. Over 2 million people have signed a petition to have the feature removed from Netflix. Interestingly enough, the 46-minute Christmas special is reported to have offended both Christians and Muslims. I haven't watched First Temptation myself, nor do I intend to, so the brief description I'm going to provide here will be coming from secondary sources. From what I've read in the short episode, the make-believe Mary is depicted as smoking cannabis, and the fake Christ hallucinates after drinking a special tea, and encounters Buddha, Krishna, and Allah, who is not shown on screen, by the way. The character of Orlando, who is a companion of the pseudo-Jesus, suggests that the two had engaged in man-male intercourse. Towards the end, Orlando is revealed to be Satan. There's a whole lot of other disgusting stuff that I read about that was in the feature, which I am not going to mention here, because it really isn't worth repeating. Netflix is currently standing by the production, saying it's simply satire, and that the film's creators are using their freedom to express diverse views. On December 26th, it was reported that a Molotov cocktail was tossed at the production company's headquarters. I think the first question that most true believers have is probably the same. Why is it that the entertainment elites, regardless of their country of origin, always seem to want to mock Jesus and not any other religious leader? Why is it that we almost never see movies that ridicule Krishna, Buddha, or Muhammad? Oh, that's right, because Jesus is the way and the truth and the life. And of course, mocking the true God-man is nothing new. Our Redeemer was blasphemed in his own day. In John 15, Jesus said that if the world hates us, know that it hated him well before it hated us. Christ's jealous contemporaries called him Beelzebul, the ruler of the demons. They also accused him of being demon-possessed. And many Christian scholars like Kim Riddlebarger have pointed out that the title, Son of Mary, was most likely an insulting pejorative used to suggest the illegitimacy of our Lord's birth. Now, I know Muslims don't use it in that way, but Christ's first century opponents in all likelihood did. Additionally, in the second century, a Greek philosopher named Celsus wrote a book called The True Word, in which he attempted to refute Christianity. Celsus' name-calling and mockery tactics are very similar to many atheists and agnostics today. In his book, Celsus first introduces a Jew who accuses the mother of Jesus of adultery with a soldier named Panthera. This Jew then adduces the denial of Peter, the treachery of Judas, and the death of Jesus as contradictions of Christ's quote-unquote pretended divinity, and makes the resurrection an imposture. Then Celsus begins with his own attack by going after the entire concept of the supernatural, which the Greek philosopher believed was the common foundation for both Jews and Christians. To Celsus, the controversy between Jews and Christians appeared as foolish to him as the strife about the shadow of a donkey. This same type of ridicule, of course, continues today with blasphemous productions such as this one. And to be honest, there's nothing really to interact with here. I mean, with something like the Da Vinci Code, there was reason for Christian scholars to respond and point out that Dan Brown's claims were completely fallacious, since Mr. Brown asserted that his novel was based on historical facts, when in reality it was based on nothing but pure fiction. But with First Temptation, it's just simply blasphemy and mockery, which is why I suppose we haven't seen leading Christian apologists like Dr. Moeller and Dr. White even bother to provide criticisms. It's also possible they haven't even heard about it since it's a Brazilian production. I've been around a while, so when I see this type of blasphemy, it doesn't really rattle me. I'm old enough to remember when The Last Temptation of Christ came out in 1988. Like this Brazilian piece, it also created a lot of buzz. Last Temptation had a lot of weird stuff in it, especially in relation to Mary Magdalene. Towards the end, the fake Jesus encounters the fake Paul, preaching about the Messiah. The pseudo-Christ tries to tell the make-believe Paul that his message about the resurrection and ascension are false, and that salvation can't be founded upon lies. But the fake Paul is unmoved, and says that even if his message is not the truth, it's what the world needs to hear, and nothing will stop him from proclaiming it. Ah, Hollywood. I suppose the title of the current 2019 film is a play on the words of Scorsese's Last Temptation. When John MacArthur was asked about Last Temptation, his response was, "That's not the real Jesus. Hollywood can have him." Which I thought was a really good response. In 2 Corinthians 11, Paul talks about people preaching a different Jesus. In context, the apostle is talking about the false teachers of his day. But we can certainly apply this text to the pseudo-Christs of groups like the Jehovah's Witnesses, the Latter-day Saints, and of course the creators of this blasphemous Netflix feature. In summation, like Scorsese's Last Temptation, First Temptation will be a flash in the pan that is quickly forgotten, and the eternal gospel of the true and living Christ will continue to be preached with full force across the world, and the kingdom of King Jesus will continue to grow and grow until our Redeemer returns. Ladies and gents, if you have your own thoughts, be sure to leave them in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching, guys. If you liked that video, please give it a thumbs up. If you like the content on this channel, you can subscribe by clicking on the icon on the bottom right, and then you can hit the bell for notifications. I upload a new video every Wednesday and every Saturday. Have an awesome week, and for my brothers and sisters in the Lord, may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all always. I will see you all in the next video. God's blessings on your week.